Hello students, how are you all? In last class you learned nitric acid. In that preparation, properties and uses of nitric acid. The today's topic is oxides of nitrogen. Now let us look at the what are the oxides of nitrogen. Nitrogen forms a number of oxides in different oxidation states. Nitrogen forms number of oxides in different oxidation states. Nitrogen forms number of oxides in a different oxidation states. Now let us discuss the number of oxides in the form. We should learn the number of oxides in a tabular form. So I'm taking the first serial number. The first one is serial number. Next formula of oxide. And third column is a name of oxide. Simply name. And this column is a oxidation state. Oxidation state of nitrogen. This is oxidation state of nitrogen. Next, common methods of preparation. The next one is physical appearance. Physical appearance or physical state. Physical appearance or physical state. This is chemical nature. And this is color. So this is serial number, formula of oxide, name, oxidation state of nitrogen, common methods of preparation, physical appearance of oxide, chemical nature and color. First I am taking serial number 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So totally we have 6 types of oxides here. The first one is I'm taking a N2O. First oxide is a N2O. So name of this oxide is a two nitrogen, we can use a dinitrogen. Only one oxygen is there. We can write monoxide. The name of this N2 is dinitrogen monoxide. We can call it also laughing gas. Next, second oxide I am taking N2O after. First I am writing oxides NO. Next I am writing N2O3. Next I am writing NO2. Next I am writing N2O4. Next N2O5. So all these are the different types of oxides. The first one is N2O, N2O, NO, N2O3, NO2, N2O4 and N2O5. These are the different types of oxides. Next, I wrote already name of this one, N2O, dinitrogen monoxide. It is also called as a laughing gas. Its name. Next, NO. Name of this compound is only one nitrogen is there. You can write nitrogen. Nitrogen monoxide. Whenever the 2 or 3 is nitrogen, we have to mention di, tri and so on. So oxygen is there, we have to mention 1 oxygen is mono, 2 oxygen is di, 3 oxygen is tri and so on. 4 oxygen is a tetra. 1 oxygen mono, 2 oxygen di, 3 oxygen tri, 4 oxygen, 4 oxygen tetra, 5 oxygen penta and so on. Next NO, nitrogen monoxide. Only 1 oxygen is there, nitrogen monoxide. Next N2O3, 2 nitrogen is there, then we have right name is dinitrogen, 3 oxygen is there, we have to write trioxide, dinitrogen trioxide. This NO2 name is nitrogen, how many oxygen is there, 2 oxygen, we can write dioxide. N2O4, number of nitrogens is 2, then we can use dinitrogen, how many oxygens, 4, then we have to use oxide, dinitrogen tetraoxide. N2O5, N2O in the sense dinitrogen. Then how many oxygens? 5 oxygens, 5 oxygens we have right, pentoxide, pentoxide. So one nitrogen mono, 2 oxygens di, 3 oxygens tri, 4 oxygens tetra, 5 oxygens penta and so on. So these are the names of oxides, di, N2O, NO, N2O3, NO2, N2O4 and N2O5, oxide names. Next, oxidation state of nitrogen in the compound. So an example will take, I'm taking N2O. So what is oxidation number of nitrogen, we have to find. So what is oxidation number, find, let it as X. So how many nitrogens is it? 2 nitrogen, this is 2X. Plus each oxygen is, oxidation number is minus 2. And the sum of the oxidation numbers is equal to 0. Then 2X is equal, 2X minus 2 is equal to 0, X is equal to plus 1. The oxidation number of nitrogen in the case is plus 1. Next, so similarly we have to find out. So nitrogen, already similar way we have to follow for remaining cases. So when I find the remaining ones, you have to follow similar pattern. Next, nitrogen. So nitrogen is X, each oxygen is minus 2. So it will get X minus 2 is equal to 0, X is equal to plus 2. Here oxidation number of nitrogen is plus 2, isn't it? Then N2O3, what is oxidation number of nitrogen N2O3? N2O3 is going to get expected plus 3 oxidation number, isn't it? So if you want, you can take this N2O3, this is 2X plus minus 2 into 3 is equal to 0. Then this is 2X minus 6 is equal to 0, X is equal to what? Plus 3, isn't it? Oxidation number of N2O3 is plus 3. So similarly, we have to follow for NO2 oxidation number is plus 4. NO2 oxidation number is plus 4. N2O4 also is plus 4. Both the cases will get plus 4 only. Next, N2O5, oxidation number is plus 5. So oxidation number of N2O5 is plus 5. So NO2, N2O4, N2O5 cases, so to find the oxidation numbers, we have to follow similar way. So any case, to find the oxidation numbers, we have to follow similar method. Next, by taking oxidation numbers also, we are able to write the name of these oxides. So here the oxidation number of this oxide is plus 1. So by taking this plus 1, we can write the name of this this oxide. NO2, we can write as oxidation number is only 1 will be there. The name of this oxide we can write R, nitrogen oxidation number is 1, we can take a Roman letter 1 in a bracket, nitrogen 1 oxide simply. So based on the oxidation number, we are writing nitrogen 1 oxide, this one we have to place in a bracket in the form of Roman letter place in a bracket. Next, NO plus 2, then what is the name we can expect in this case? What is the name? Nitrogen 2 oxide, oxidation number is 2. Nitrogen 2 oxide, it is nitrogen 2 oxide. Then it is also called as a nitric oxide, another name, nitric oxide. Another name is a nitric oxide. Nitrogen monoxide, nitrogen 2 oxide, nitric oxide, all names belongs to the NO only. Next, plus 3 here, plus 3 in the sense, what is the name you can expect? Nitrogen 3 oxide, it is nitrogen 3 oxide. Oxidation number is 4, then you can write its name is R, nitrogen 4 oxide, nitrogen 4 oxide. This is a nitrogen, next here also plus 4 is there, then it is also nitrogen 4 oxide, nitrogen 4 oxide. So both the cases, the name is nitrogen 4 oxide. Nitrogen 4 oxide belongs to NO2 and N2O4. So NO2 will be dimerized to form N2O4. NO2 will be dimerized. What am I meaning is NO2 dimer, you can take 2 nitrogens and double the number of oxygens, N2O4. If you take dimerization, we'll get N2O4. So here the oxidation number of NO2 and N2O4 is plus 4 and plus 4 only, because N2O4 is the dimer of NO2. NO2 dimerizes to form N2O4, so that we have same oxidation number. Name is nitrogen 4 oxide, nitrogen 4 oxide only. But if you take this case, nitrogen dioxide, he is get dinitrogen tetraoxide. So next one is plus 5, oxidation number is plus 5. Oxidation number is plus 5 in the sense, what is the name we can expect? Nitrogen 5 oxide. nitrogen 5 oxide. So this is the another names for oxides on the basis of a writing of oxidation numbers of nitrogen, oxidation number of nitrogen. So N2O oxidation number, N2O oxidation number is plus 1, NO oxidation number is plus 2, N2O oxidation number is plus 3, NO2 and N2O4 oxidation number is plus 4, N2O5 oxidation number is plus 5. So based on the oxidation numbers we wrote another name. So these are the names and oxidation number and formula for oxides. Next, common methods of preparation. Common methods of preparation of oxides. In that first one, preparation of N2O, nothing but laughing gas. I am taking ammonium nitrate, NH4NO3, upon heating. So ammonium nitrate upon heating, the product is N2O plus 2H2O. N2O plus 2H2O. So we got one product is N2O, dinitrogen monoxide, nothing but laughing gas is the product. This is the common method of preparation of N2O. Next, NO. For this case, I am taking NaNO2 plus FeSO4 plus HNO3. H2SO4. Then what is the product we are going to get expected from this case? I'm writing like this. Products what we are expecting is one product is NO, 2NO plus another product is Fe2SO4 taken thrice. Fe2SO4 taken thrice. We will balance later. Fe2SO4 taken thrice. Plus another product is NaHSO4. NaHSO4 plus another product is water. So these are the product formula. We have to balance it. Here I am taking is 2NaNO2. We will get 2NaHSO4. Here I am taking Fe2, 2. This is 2 times. Then this is 3 I am taking. So here is you get this is 2NO2, 2NO. So these are the products formula. Our product is 2NO. Next, third one, preparation of N2O3. So in the case of preparation of N2O, this is for N2O3. I'm taking NO plus N2O4. NO plus N2O4. Then the product is N2O3. This you can take 2 times. Then we have to balance it. This you can take 2NO. Then count of number of nitrogen is 2 plus 2, 4. Oxygen, 4 plus 2, 6. 2, 3 is 6. The product is N2NO plus N2O4 gives rise to 2N2O3. So next, NO2. So NO2 preparation, we have take lead nitrate. PbNO3 taken twice. We have take PbNO3 taken twice, lead nitrate. Upon heating. So upon heating of lead nitrate, the product is lead oxide. Lead oxide plus nitrogen dioxide plus another product is oxygen. So three products, we have to balance it. This is 2PbO. Next, number of nitrogens, NO2. 4 is there. 2 are 4. 4NO2 plus O2. So the product is NO2. Next is N2O4. This is a dimer. Dimer in the sense we have to take NO2 dimerizes. You can take 2 times. Upon cooling the product is N2O4. If you heat this one, you'll get NO2. So heat. So upon cooling of NO2, we'll get dimerizes N2O4. If you heat it, then we'll get nitrogen dioxide. So this is the common method preparation of N2O4. Next, last one is N2O5. N2O5 can be prepared by HNO3. HNO3 treating with P4O10. P4O10. So HNO3 plus P4O10. Then the product is N2O5 or HPO3 plus N2O5. So here I am taking 4, here also we will get 4. Next, number of nitrogens 4, then you can take 2. So HPO3 plus N2O5. So these are the common methods of preparation of different oxides. Next, physical appearance. What is the physical state of these oxides? N2O, it is a gas. N2O is a gas. Next to NO, it is also a gas state. NO is also a gas. Next to N2O3. N2O3 is a solid. N2O3 is a solid. Next to NO2. NO2 is a gas. NO2 is a gas. Next to N2O4. This can exist as a solid or a solid or liquid. This may be solid or a liquid. And N2O5, this is a solid. So these are the physical state of these compounds, physical state of these oxides. So first two are gases, N2O3 is a solid, NO2 is a gas, N2O4 is a solid or liquid, and N2O5 is a solid state. This is the physical state, nothing but physical appearance. Next, chemical nature. Chemical nature, N2O is a neutral oxide. Neutral. Even NO also neutral oxide. So N2O and NO are neutral oxides. Next, remaining all the cases. Next, all oxides are acidic. Next, remaining what is NO2 is also acidic oxide. Next, N2O4 acidic. Next, N2O5 acidic. All these are acidic oxides. Next, color. In the case of color, this is colorless. It is colorless. NO also colorless. NO is also a colorless. N2O3 is a blue color. N2O3 is blue color. NO2 is a brown color. Brown color. N2O4 is a colorless. And N2O5 also colorless. Color less. So this is the physical appearance, physical state, chemical nature and color, and these are the some common methods of preparation of oxides of nitrogen. So these are the names and formula of oxides, oxidation states. So these are the oxides of nitrogen. Oxide nitrogen form number of oxides in a different oxidation states. So this is the oxides of nitrogen. Next, phosphorus. In that first topic, allotropic forms of phosphorus. Allotropic forms of phosphorus. Simply allotropy of phosphorus. So first we need to understand what is allotropy. Allotropy is nothing but the existence of element in two or more different forms. So generally we have to refer to as allotropy. Allotropy is nothing but the existence of an element in two or more different forms. So we have to refer as allotropy. Now let us understand what is the meaning of allotropy by taking one familiar example. The familiar example I'm taking here is carbon. So I'm taking for understanding allotropy, I'm taking familiar example carbon. So carbon can exist in different allotropic forms. So the first one I'm taking is a diamond. So very, very familiar, diamond is very familiar to us. Next, it exists in the form of graphite, diamond, graphite. Another one is coal. Coal is very familiar to us. So these are the different allotropic forms of carbon. Many will be there. I'm taking one more, fullerenes. Fullerene. So these are the some allotropic forms of carbon. If you look at diamond, the diamond is made up of only one element, that single element is none other than carbon. Only one single element is there. In diamond, the diamond is made up of only one single element, that is carbon. Even graphite is made up of one single element, so that element is carbon. Even coal also contain carbon, even fullerenes also contain carbon. So main element is here is carbon. Now the point is one element. So an element exists in different forms. So this is one form, this is another form. So this is another form and this is another form. So one element exists in a different forms. Different forms we have to refer as allotropy. So allotropy is nothing but existence of element in two or more different forms is referred as allotropy. This point of meaning I'm writing. Existence of element in two or more different forms. Generally we have it referred as a allotropy. So existence of element in two or more different forms is referred as allotropy. And the next one is we are discussing about allotropy forms of phosphorus. The phosphorus exist in different allotropy forms. They are the first one is white phosphorus, red phosphorus, black phosphorus, violet phosphorus, etc. So the phosphorus also has many allotropy forms. So in our syllabus we have mainly three. They are the first one is white phosphorus. The first one is white phosphorus, the second one is black red phosphorus. The second one is red phosphorus, third one is black phosphorus. Black phosphorus. So white phosphorus, red phosphorus, black phosphorus. So all these white phosphorus, red phosphorus, black phosphorus made up of only one single element, that is nothing but phosphorus. They are made up of element phosphorus in a different forms. So here phosphorus also exhibit allotropy. Now we'll discuss the different allotropy forms of phosphorus. First we'll discuss one by one, white, red as well as black phosphorus. Now we'll discuss one by one in detail. Next to white phosphorus, this is the first allotropic form, white phosphorus. In that point number one, white phosphorus is a translucent white waxy solid. First read the point. It is a translucent white waxy solid. So white phosphorus is a translucent white waxy solid. So what is the meaning of waxy solid? It is a translucent, meaning is a semi-transparent. This is semi-transparent. So light passes through the white phosphorus. It is a semi-transparent material substance. And the next one is white phosphorus is a poisonous substance. It is a poisonous substance. Next one is white phosphorus is soluble in water and insoluble in carbon disulfide. Its solubility, in the case of solubility, whenever the white phosphorus is added to the water, then the white phosphorus is soluble in water. But white phosphorus is added to the carbon disulfide CS2, it is insoluble. So let us get the point. It is soluble in water and insoluble in carbon disulfide. Insoluble in carbon disulfide, nothing but CS2. So here the water is a solvent, even CS2 is a solvent, carbon disulfide is a solvent, even water also a solvent, both are solvents. So it is soluble in water and insoluble in carbon disulfide. So and the next point is it glows in dark. Whenever the white phosphorus is placed in a dark, the white phosphorus glows. This phenomenon we have to call as a chemiluminescence. Whenever the white phosphorus is placed in a dark, the white phosphorus will glow. So this phenomenon we have to call as chemiluminescence. It glows in dark. This phenomenon we have to call as a chemiluminescence. Chemiluminescence. It glows in a dark. Next, white phosphorus contains a discrete tetrahedral molecule. It is a discrete tetrahedral P4 molecule. Discrete tetrahedral P4 molecule. First, what is this point meaning is, let us take an example, a structure. I'm taking P4 structure, phosphorus exists in the form of a P4. So I'm writing its structure. First, phosphorus. Look at this. So this is one phosphorus atom, this is the another phosphorus atom, this is the another one, this is the another one. So these are the four phosphorus atoms. The structure is look like a tetrahedral. This is a tetrahedral. Tetrahedral P4 molecule. So phosphorus exists in the form of a tetrahedral P4, tetrahedral P4 molecule. And the angle between these two bonds, the angle between these two bonds will be taken as 60 degrees. The angle is 60 degrees. And another important point is, this P4 molecules are held together by van der Waals forces. Discrete tetrahedral P4 molecules, single units, the discrete tetrahedral P4 molecules are held together by van der Waals forces. This is the one molecule. I'm taking another molecule for understanding purpose. This is another molecule, P4 molecule. So these are the phosphorus atoms. So P4 molecule, here also the angle is 60 degrees. So this is one molecule and this is another molecule, P4 molecule, P4 molecule. Like that, many number of molecules we can take. So between these two molecules, between the molecules of phosphorus, that means P4 molecules, there is a van der Waals force of attraction. So these discrete tetrahedral P4 molecules are held together by van der Waals forces. Read the statement. These discrete tetrahedral P4 molecules are held together by van der Waals forces. So this is relating to the structure of a P4 molecule. Next, it's a P4 molecule is less stable. P4 molecule is less stable and highly reactive. So it is less stable. P4 molecule is less stable and more reactive. P4 molecule is less stable and more reactive. So why the P4 molecule is less stable and more reactive than other solid phases? Other solid phases, you can compare with other allotropic forms. You have red phosphorus and black phosphorus. When compared to the red phosphorus and black phosphorus, the white phosphorus is less stable and more reactive. So it is less stable and more reactive than other solid phases. What is the reason behind it? So the reason you can explain on the basis of its structure. So if you look at the structure, this is the angle between the two bonds is 60 degrees. So bonds are very close to each other. Whenever the bonds are very close to each other, there is a angular strain will be happened. Due to angular strain, the bond will be easily cleavage. As a result, its reactivity is going to be more. So the reason it is less stable and more reactive than other solid phases, because angular strain, because of this angular strain, this bonds will easily undergo cleavage. Because of angular strain, it is more reactive. And the bond angle are simply angle, and the angle is 60 degrees. And next point, it readily catches fire in air to give dense white fumes of P4O10. It readily catches fire in air. It readily catches fire in air, gives dense white fumes. Dense white fumes of P4O10. So let us write the equation for this case. I'm taking a P4. P4 react with oxygen, O2 gives rise to P4O10. In this case, we have to balance 5 oxygens. Is the first we have to balance 4 phosphorus is here. I'm taking it is the P4 already balanced. The here number of oxygens is 2. Here number of oxygens is 10. You can take it as a 5O2. So this is the equation. It react. It readily catches fire in air. Gives a dense white fumes of P4O10. So next one is it dissolves in a boiling NaOH. It dissolve in a boiling NaOH. Gives in boiling NaOH in a inert atmosphere. In a inert atmosphere gives phosphine, nothing but PH3. Let us write the equation for it. I'm taking a white phosphorus P4. This is white phosphorus. White phosphorus react with sodium hydroxide NaOH plus water. Plus water, and the product is phosphine PH3 plus NaH PO2. NaH2PO2. This is nothing but phosphine. So this is a phosphine. This is a sodium hypophosphite. Sodium hypophosphite. We have to balance it. This I'm taking is a 3 NaOH. I'm taking is a 3H2O. Here is a 3NaH2PO2. This is sodium hypophosphite. Here is the product is a phosphine. So white phosphorus dissolve in boiling NaOH in inert atmosphere gives phosphine is the product. This is the product. So this is information relating to the white phosphorus. So white phosphorus is a translucent white wax solid. It is a semi-translucent. It is a poisonous substance, and it is soluble in water and insoluble in carbon disulfide. It glows in dark. This phenomenon we have to call as a chemiluminescence. Its structure contains P4 units. It is a P4 molecule, tetrahedral P4 molecules. Molecules are held together by van der Waal forces. Next, it is less stable and more reactive. So the P4 white phosphorus is less stable and more reactive. It is mainly due to the angular strain. This is important point. Due to angular strain, the angle between the two bonds is 60 degrees. Because of angular strain, the bonds undergo cleavage and readily will be reactive. So because of high reactivity, it is less stable, and it readily catches fire in air, gives white dense white fumes of P4O10. So phosphorus, white phosphorus is stored in a water because of its high reactivity in presence of moisture. Next, it dissolves in boiling NaOH in an atmosphere gives a phosphine. So I give the reaction. Whenever the white phosphorus reacts with sodium hydroxide, the product is phosphine. So this is information relating to the white phosphorus. Next, red phosphorus. This is a second one. Red phosphorus. In that first point, red phosphorus is a amorphous solid. It is amorphous solid. The second one is it has a iron gray luster. It has iron gray luster.
And the third one is it is orderless. It is orderless.
It is orderless. We don't get any smell relating to it. It is orderless.
And the fourth one is it insoluble in water as well as carbon disulfide. It insoluble. It insoluble in water as well as
insoluble in water as well as a
carbon disulfide. Carbon disulfide, nothing but we can take it as a CS2.
So whenever the red phosphorus is added to the water, it is insoluble, and it is insoluble even carbon disulfide. And another important point is it is less reactive. It is less reactive when compared with the white phosphorus. White phosphorus is more reactive and less stable. It is less reactive and when compared with the white phosphorus,
it is less reactive. Less reactive than white phosphorus. White phosphorus. Less reactive than white phosphorus.
So that means white phosphorus is more reactive than red phosphorus. And another important point relating to the red phosphorus is it do not glow in dark. It do not glow in dark. So red phosphorus do not glow in dark. That means it do not show any chemiluminescence. So opposite to that white phosphorus, whenever the white phosphorus is placed in a dark room, whenever the white phosphorus is in a dark, then the white phosphorus will glow. That means chemiluminescence. White phosphorus will show chemiluminescence, but red phosphorus do not show any chemiluminescence. Nothing but it do not glow in a dark. Another point is preparation of red phosphorus. White phosphorus on heating several days in inert atmosphere at 573 Kelvin gives red phosphorus. So white phosphorus on heating several days in inert atmosphere at 573 Kelvin gives red phosphorus. So first I'm writing equation. White phosphorus nothing but it is P4. So P4 is converting into white phosphorus, converting into red phosphorus. So white phosphorus converting into red phosphorus at 573 Kelvin. So white phosphorus on heating several days in a atmosphere at 573 Kelvin gives red phosphorus. Write the statement. White phosphorus on heating several days in a inert atmosphere at 573 Kelvin gives red phosphorus. So this is the equation relating to it. Next, structure relating to the red phosphorus. Red phosphorus has a polymeric structure. It has polymeric structure. It has polymeric structure containing chains of P4 tetrahedra linked together through a covalent bonds. It has polymeric structure containing chains of P4 tetrahedra. Chains of P4 tetrahedra linked together through a covalent bonds. So let us write the structure of red phosphorus. I'm taking a P4 unit. This is the one P4 tetrahedra. This is phosphorus atoms.
right? This one linked to this one linked to another unit. Another tetrahedra. So this is another one. Next continuation will be there. Extension will be there. This side also there is a extension. So this unit is repeating in a chain. So it has a polymeric structure and containing chains of P4 tetrahedra. It is a chains of P4 hydra linked through a covalent bond. This one and these three phosphorus are linked to a covalent bond. So this is the structure of red phosphorus. This is the information related to the red phosphorus. It is amorphous solid, iron clay lustrous, and it is odorless, insoluble in water as well as carbon disulfide. It has a less reactive. It is less reactive than white phosphorus, and it does not glow in dark. It does not show chemiluminescence. So red phosphorus prepared from the white phosphorus by heating white phosphorus on heating several days in a atmosphere at 500 Kelvin gives red phosphorus. So it has a polymeric structure. This is information relating to red phosphorus. Next, black phosphorus. This is a third one. Black phosphorus. It has two forms. One is alpha black phosphorus and the second is beta black phosphorus. It has two forms. In that first one is alpha black phosphorus. The second one is beta black phosphorus. Alpha black phosphorus and beta black phosphorus. First, let us look at the preparation of alpha black phosphorus. Alpha black phosphorus is prepared by heating red phosphorus. Heating red phosphorus in a sealed tube at 803 Kelvin gives alpha black phosphorus. So alpha black phosphorus prepared from red phosphorus. On heating red phosphorus in a sealed tube at 803 Kelvin gives alpha black phosphorus. Alpha black phosphorus. So first I'm taking a red phosphorus. Red phosphorus upon heating at 803 Kelvin. Heating at 800 Kelvin will get alpha black phosphorus. So this is the preparation of alpha black phosphorus. Alpha black phosphorus prepared from red phosphorus. Next we have is a beta black phosphorus. The second one is beta black phosphorus. Beta black phosphorus prepared by heating white phosphorus. So beta black phosphorus prepared from white phosphorus. White phosphorus on heating at 470 Kelvin under high pressure gives beta black phosphorus. On heating white phosphorus. On heating white phosphorus at 473 Kelvin, at 473 Kelvin under high pressure, gives beta black phosphorus. Then write the equation. I'm taking a white phosphorus. This is nothing but P4. So upon heating, what is the temperature? 473 Kelvin and pressure is very high. High pressure. And the product is beta black phosphorus. Beta black phosphorus. So this is the
beta black phosphorus preparation. So what the point to understand is alpha black phosphorus is obtained from alpha black phosphorus is obtained from red phosphorus, beta black phosphorus obtained from white phosphorus. So these are the black phosphorus. Black phosphorus has two forms, so alpha black as well as beta black phosphorus. This is a black phosphorus.